Subscribe to Learning and Teaching for Java and its frameworks learning. In this video, we will understand how to use HTTP methods and get access to resources. As a basic step, we need to understand what is a resource first. The resources are the things that are residing in the web server which you want to and access for. Assume this is a web server which you can see on the screen. The resource sits inside the web server. So as I said, the resources are the things that are residing in the web server which you want to and access for. Assume you have a school management system and the resources in the application can be student, faculty, staff. So to access these resources, we will add REST controllers with request mapping and try to get an access. So how do we write REST controllers with request mapping? Click on the above link to understand how to write REST controllers with request mapping. So how do we access these resources? REST provides standard methods such as get, put, post, and delete. For the student resource, if we use get slash students, as you can see on the screen, it gets all the students, right? A list of all the students. So what if I need a single student resource? For the student resource, if we use get slash students slash ID, it gets the particular student. Okay, now how do we create a new student? For the student resource, if we use post slash students, it creates a new student, right? If a new information needs to be updated, we should use the put method. For the student resource, if we use put slash students slash ID, it updates the student, right? There is one more HTTP method called delete to delete a resource. For the student resource, if we use delete slash students slash ID, it deletes the student. So these are the basic things one should know to build a REST API using Spring Boot. Thank you for watching.